Have you ever thought about owning a car in New York City? Well, demystify the topic of car ownership in this video. I'm Nick at Hauseit. Check out our website, hauseit.com, to learn about ways to save money on commission when buying and selling real estate in New York City, Long Island, and the Hudson Valley. So let's get started. So, why own a car in New York City? Well, New York City's proximity to the Hudson Valley, Long Island, the Hamptons, hiking outdoor areas, farms, and numerous beaches in New York and New Jersey provide a plethora of day and weekend trips which are less than 2 hours from the city. These types of trips are particularly appealing if you're tired of the repetitive drinking and eating scene here in New York City. And for the more adventurous, there are several other great destinations a bit farther away, such as Lake George in upstate New York, which is approximately a 4 hour drive from New York City. It's also possible to drive to other major cities, such as Philadelphia and Baltimore, which are 2 and 3 hours from New York City, respectively. A car can also be used in the winter for weekend ski trips and for apple, berry, or pumpkin picking during the warmer months. Owning a car makes it considerably easier to go on spontaneous trips or book things last minute compared to renting a car, which is a major turnoff and source of stress for many New Yorkers who would otherwise love to leave the city from time to time. How much does it cost to own a car in New York City? Well, the cost of owning a car in Manhattan with garage parking is roughly $500 a month for parking, $200 a month for insurance, say around $11 a month for AAA roadside assistance, plus your actual car or lease payment. Now, leasing an entry-level BMW, such as a 228 Xi, for around $400 a month means your monthly cost would be roughly $1,100, or roughly $13,000 a year, excluding gas, tolls, registration, inspections, and maintenance. If you opt to lease a less expensive car, such as a Mazda CX-30 for say $275 a month, your total cost would be roughly $985, or say $12,000 a year. Now, Manhattan residents receive a small discount on parking through the Manhattan Resident Parking Tax Exemption, but all this does is equalize the sales tax rate on parking to what it is in other boroughs, such as Brooklyn. But if you're looking for even bigger savings, you may want to park your car in Brooklyn. This could make a lot of sense if you live on the east side of Lower Manhattan, as you can easily take the subway just a few stops across the river or hop on a city bike, e-bike, or electric scooter to cross the Williamsburg Bridge. Now, the figures we've talked about might sound like a lot of money. However, if you rent a car to take weekend trips more than twice a month, the math of owning a car starts to make sense versus continuing to rent cars. And of course, you can pay considerably less per month than in our examples above by purchasing a beater car, as they call it, and parking it on the street, meaning the only thing you're responsible for, aside from maintenance, registration, inspections, etc., is insurance. Now, skimping on garage parking is not for the faint of heart, and if you choose to, prepare yourself to spend hours each week moving your car around in the early mornings and fending off traffic enforcement and parking officers. The math of owning a car makes even more sense if you're part of a multiple earner household, or if you already find yourself spending considerable amounts of money on transportation for weekend getaways and other trips outside the city. Should I lease or buy a car in New York City? Well, we recommend leasing a car versus buying in New York City. The main reason why it's better to lease is because you'll have a newer car, which in theory means less time handling repairs and maintenance or dealing with out-of-warranty repairs, particularly if you buy a used car. Most mechanics are far out in Queens or Brooklyn, so it's a major logistical headache and time killer every time your car needs work. An additional benefit of a lease is the fact that you won't have to deal with selling or otherwise disposing of your car later down the line. Once your lease expires, you simply drive it back to the dealership and hand over the keys. Moreover, some dealers will forgive small damage or excess mileage if you agree to lease a new car with them. Trying to sell a used car in New York City can be a huge drain on your time and energy, and the alternative is to use it as a trade-in at a dealer, but dealers will always offer less than a private party. The other advantage of a lease is that you can upgrade your car every few years. Not to mention, lease payments are generally lower than financing payments. Cost and inconvenience of rental cars. Many New Yorkers often rationalize not having a car by thinking it's cheaper to rent one whenever there's a need to go on a trip outside the city. While this might be true if you rarely leave New York City, renting a car is not a viable option if you see yourself leaving the city for a weekend more than once a month. Now, this is because renting a car in New York City is nothing short of a nightmare. Rental cars in the city itself, and Manhattan in particular, are a rare commodity. There's not very many of them, which means that prices are sky high. Figure at least $250 a day if you plan on picking up a rental car in Manhattan, not including the cost of insurance. You can literally lease a car for an entire month for less than the cost of renting a car in New York City for a single day. What's worse is that there aren't too many cars available in Manhattan anyway. So if you don't book that overpriced rental car at least a week in advance, you're completely out of luck, even if you're willing to pay big money. While it's possible to pay less for the car rental itself by picking up the vehicle at, say, JFK, Newark, or LaGuardia, where there are more cars, this means that you'll be on the hook for a costly Uber or Lyft to and from the airport. This immediately reduces any cost savings versus simply renting a car in Manhattan in the first place. It also wastes time and creates additional logistical work. And even if car rental rates in New York City were more reasonable, it wouldn't be worth it to go down this route if you did weekend or day trips outside the city more than once a month. And here's why. The truth is that renting a car in New York City is an absolutely miserable experience. New York City as a whole is not known for its friendly staff and good customer service, and airport rental car locations in particular represent the very worst of New York City. Rude staff, lines, wait times, plus the laborious check-in process and annoying upsells, think insurance, easy pass, etc. And all of this when you're most likely in a hurry to get your car. Simply put, a weekend getaway to Lake George or a visit to Philadelphia isn't so relaxing or enjoyable if you have to start your journey by speaking with a miserable rental car attendant at an airport car rental venue. In addition, most rental car companies charge obscene rates of up to $11 a gallon or more if you forget to fill your tank before returning the car. So in addition to being stressed and unhappy about coming back to the city after your getaway and starting work the next day, you'll have the added stress of remembering to fill up the gas tank before a certain time when your car rental must be dropped off. Tolls and potholes. New York City's roads are hazardous, plain and simple. If you're driving in New York City, avoiding potholes is the single most important objective, aside from not hitting pedestrians, cyclists, or other vehicles. Some of the potholes on New York City streets are literally so deep and so dangerous that driving over them at full speed can result in serious damage to your car, or it will cause you to lose control and actually have an accident. We kid you not, it's very dangerous on the streets of New York City. If you buy a car, we suggest avoiding coupes, sports cars, or anything that has less ground clearance than a standard four-door sedan. An SUV is another option, very good for the roads here in New York City. However, we don't recommend this because SUV parking in a garage is considerably more expensive than for a regular car. They have lower gas mileage, higher tolls, and they're considerably harder to parallel park. In addition to potholes, New York City is surrounded by a myriad of toll roads. The most egregious tolls are for the Holland and Lincoln tunnels, George Washington, Bayonne, bridges, and the Outer Borough crossing, all of which have a $16 cash toll or $13.75 using EasyPass during peak hours when entering New York. Think about that, $16, that's the cost literally of having lunch, just for driving over a bridge. Although tolls are high when entering New York, they're generally pretty expensive on other roads. Moreover, you're still responsible for the tolls when renting a car. So the cost of tolls itself shouldn't be a primary decision-making factor when thinking about whether or not to buy a car in New York City. High cost of insurance and deductibles. Auto insurance rates in New York City are considerably higher versus other parts of the country. Basic coverage for an average car will exceed $100 a month, and the cost can easily go north of $200 a month if you buy a premium vehicle, such as a Mercedes or a BMW, or opt for higher coverage limits and/or a lower deductible. Even if you have insurance, having a car in New York City is still a headache because of the high likelihood someone will do something to your car, be it ding it, scuff it, or damage your car when you're parked. You'll inevitably have to pay your deductible to cover these repairs, or you can expect to pay out of pocket for any small repairs over the course of ownership. If you lease a car and don't fix the damage, the cost of any such repairs will come out of your pocket when you return the vehicle. In addition to the cost of insurance, you'll also need to pay for AAA or some other form of roadside assistance to cover you for tows in the event your car breaks down. As of this filming, AAA plans range from $4.50 to $11 a month. Cost of garage parking. Garage parking in New York City ranges from $200 to $700 a month. The cost of a covered lot in Manhattan is closer to $500 or $700 a month, which is roughly the same monthly cost of leasing an entry-range BMW, Audi, or Mercedes. If you plan on parking in Manhattan, beware of long wait times during rush hour at busier and larger parking lots for the attendant to bring your car. Don't think for a second that just because you're paying $700 a month, you won't have to wait in line when you're trying to pick up your car on a Friday evening. Garage parking prices are slightly less expensive in Brooklyn and Queens, at say $200 to $300 a month. Outdoor, uncovered lots can be had for less, and it's possible to find certain condo, co-op, and rental buildings with discounted parking rates for residents, although many have long wait lists. If you live in Brooklyn, Queens, or the Bronx, it's also possible to negotiate parking with a homeowner in the neighborhood. There are many creative ways to save money on parking in the outer boroughs. Traffic and parking tickets. Street parking in New York City is not for the faint of heart. It's hard enough to find a parking spot and navigate alternate side parking, let alone avoid being ticketed by any of the thousands of NYPD parking enforcement personnel who roam the city literally 24/7 looking for offenders. With COVID-19 having decimated New York City's finances, we anticipate that the number of traffic violations and parking tickets will surge over the coming years as the city looks to raise additional revenue. Mass transit, cycling, and rideshares. The main argument against owning a car in New York City is that you can easily get around the city itself and travel to many nearby destinations using a myriad of public transit options, including the subway, LIRR, Metro North, and Citibike. And this is a valid argument. We fully agree that there is a very long list of places you can travel for a day and for a weekend trip using public transit alone. That being said, public transit schedules can be inconvenient. And there's also the constant threat of delays, plus general unreliability, and the fact that tickets for the LIRR and the Metro North aren't even that cheap to begin with. If you're trying to elevate your lifestyle and weekend game, constantly taking trains isn't going to make you feel like you've conquered New York City and become liberated in the same way that owning a car will make you feel. There are also car sharing platforms such as Zipcar, which might make sense for day trips, but they don't necessarily make sense for routine overnight trips away from the city due to higher overnight rates. We hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please like, subscribe, and leave us a comment. We'd greatly appreciate it. And if you end up buying a car, please let us know what you end up purchasing or leasing by leaving a comment below. I'm Nick at Hauseit, and we'll see you on the next video.